Welcome to the Climate Water Outlook for April to June 2017. We've moved to El Niño Watch, and outlook suggests a warm and dry season ahead. But it may not start out that way. Before we get to the outlooks, let's look at recent conditions. Summer heat extended into March for much of the country. Victoria and Tasmania both had their warmest March on record. But southwest Western Australia bucked the trend, with temperatures around average for the month. Large parts of the east switched from very hot and dry in February to warm and wet in March. Far eastern and northeastern parts of New South Wales had 2 to 3 times their usual March rainfall by mid-month. This has cancelled out most of the recent rainfall deficiencies. And severe tropical cyclone Debbie brought heavy rains, flooding, and extensive damage to the east coast late in the month. For most of northern Australia, wet season rainfall has been above average, particularly in the west, the result of a vigorous monsoon trough and a high number of tropical lows. However, unusually few of these lows have turned into tropical cyclones. So far, we've only seen 5 cyclones in our region, well under the average of 11. In the eastern tropics, the monsoon trough has been less active, resulting in clearer skies. More sunshine has seen additional coral bleaching on the Great Barrier Reef this summer. Turning to soil moisture, after a very dry and hot summer in southeast Queensland and northeast New South Wales, heavy rain in March has improved conditions slightly. Wet soils in the western half of the country, the result of heavy rains in late summer, are now drying towards more average conditions. Water storage levels are far higher than this time last year, when we were near the end of a strong El Niño. So what's likely to drive Australia's climate in the coming months? The far eastern Pacific Ocean has warmed substantially, with temperatures now more than 3 degrees above average. While this is unlikely to be affecting Australia's climate right now, models suggest this local warming will spread across more of the tropical Pacific. Our ENSO outlook has moved to El Niño Watch, as 7 of 8 climate models we survey suggest El Niño during winter. So what's the rainfall outlook for April to June? Below average rainfall is likely over much of Australia, but it might not start out that way in several places. In April, tropical air may continue to bring rain to the eastern and northern coastal fringes. Turning to stream flows, while near median and low flows were seen at most locations in February, we're still analysing data from the heavy rains in March. Our next seasonal streamflow forecast will be available on the 11th of April at bom.gov.au/water/SSF. In terms of temperatures, days and nights are likely to be warmer than average for much of Australia, but cooler in some areas of the far north. So in summary, we've moved to El Niño Watch. Rainfall is likely to be below average for much of Australia, and temperatures are expected to be warmer than average. For more details, visit our website at bom.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also get updates via Facebook and Twitter. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 27th of April. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Andrew Watkins.